Go to any store around here and fulfill any of my basic needs. And beyond that, I can buy phones, TVs, whatever I want. And all I have to do to afford that is to provide an honest day's work.
I don't think everyone shares your idea of what is an honest day's work.
Sure, we pre-tape a lot of our segments and interviews, and I only really work 4 hours a day.
If we can even count that as work.
Cómico, Santiago. Muy cómico, huh? I can't help it that the market has set a high price for my services.
Not as high as the price it says for me.
What?
Nothing.
You make more than me?
The point is, Tiago, that you and I might have it slightly better than some of the other people of Solis.
Okay, maybe you have a point there.
Gracias.
But that still doesn't mean that people should resort to violence if they don't like what's going on here.
No, they shouldn't. Unless, of course, there really is no other choice.
What are you talking about, parce?
Nothing.
I didn't realize I was sitting across from such a radical.
Let's go to the phones. Looks like a lot of people want to talk about this particular issue.
Oh, wow, look at the screen. Where should we start? Okay, let's go to line two. Buenas, you're on Tiago and Santiago.
Hello, Tiago. Hello, Santiago. I love your show very much. But I have to say, I think Santiago sounds like he doesn't like Solis very much. I have no problem with this country. In fact, I love it. I may have to work for 70 hours a week in a factory to be able to pay for rent and groceries, but I get to live in the best country on earth. So, I don't want to be mean, but I may have to scrape off the Santiago half of my Tiago and Santiago bumper sticker.
Oh, do not do that, señora.
70 hours? Did you say 70 hours a week? Sí, no, you should definitely quit that job. That sounds awful. Eso, I'm not saying you need to join Santiago's revolution.
Qué tonto.
But you should try to find another job right now.
You make it sound so easy.
Gracias. Let's go to another call. Hágale, you're talking to Tiago and Santiago.
This army of the chaos people or whatever, whether they have a point or not, they seem dumb to take on the Black Hand. The Black Hand are pretty much invincible.
Eso? I personally wouldn't mess with the Black Hand.
Finally, something we can all agree on. Thanks for calling, señora. Bien, let's take one more call before break. And hola, you're on the air with Tiago and Santiago.
I have a question. Why am I even listening to you guys talk about this? It's not like we can trust your opinion. We all know who owns your station. I'll give you a hint. It's a division of Espinosa Tech.
Okay, that's great. Thank you for calling, señor. I'm thinking we should probably take a break, Santiago. ¿Sí o no?
That's probably a good idea.
Sí, along with maybe firing our phone screener. Yes, I'm talking about you, Rafael. Okay, amigos, we'll be back with more Tiago in Santiago Show.
I love these guys. Love them or hate them?
Did you hear what they said?
You never know what's going to happen next on the Tiago and Santiago Show.
When it comes to driving an automobile, there's only one name you can trust. Prisa Auto. Whether you're looking for the majestic beauty of the Prisa Sol, the dynamic thrill of the Azul 3, or the raw power of the Extendidesa, Prisa has whatever you're looking for. So, come on down to your local Prisa dealer.
On the next Jóvenes y Bellos, a family affair.
Let us go to the amusement park, mi amor.
I wish I could, but I cannot ride the roller coaster. I'm pregnant.
But how can that be? I've been sterile since the mining accident.
I know, mi amor. You are not the father.
But I am.
Gustavo.
All that and more next week on Jóvenes y Bellos.
Get off of me, huevón!
Oh, they're not gonna like that upstairs.
Cover your ears, but not if you're driving. It's Tiago and Santiago.
More Tiago and Santiago for you.
¿Qué hay, amigos?
Another amazing show brought to you by Grupo Prospero, pioneers of Solino security for over 50 years. So, Santiago?
That's a little weird, isn't it?
What is?
That we are sponsored by Grupo Prospero?
No, we have a lot of sponsors. Prisa Auto, Espinosa Telecom, Colibri. They pay somebody some money, not me personally, but somebody, and then we either mention them on the air or we produce a commercial for them and play that when you and I are not talking. It is very standard.
Sí, but I was doing some research on Grupo Prospero.
Santiago, do you know what we do not need right now?
What is that, Tiago?
We don't need a patented Santiago diatribe about one of our sponsors. Your complaining has cost us so many lucrative advertising deals over the years.
It can't be that many.
Pulso?
Well, their phones had terrible battery life.
Núcleo?
My computer could never handle Black Hand First Strike on max settings.
José Medio?
Well, their shirts made me look bloated.
Santiago?
Oiga bien, you made your point, but this is different.
How?
This is less a result of my very discriminating taste, and more from a morality point of view.
Grupo Prospero is one of the leading providers of weapons, vehicles, and munition to the Black Hand. The Black Hand protects Solis from threats, both foreign and domestic. Therefore, we want the Black Hand to have very good weapons, sí o no? Ergo...
Was that Latin?
Ergo, Grupo Prospero is a good thing, and I'm proud to have them as a sponsor for our show.
But why are they even advertising on our show? Do they have a lot of customers among our listeners? Are they hoping Esteban from Kunai is going to suddenly decide he'd like to purchase an attack helicopter to commute to the lumber mill or buy a turret to protect his backyard?
I think it's more of a public service announcement. You know, make sure that people know that they are being protected by some of the best soldiers using the best equipment.
See, but they don't only make weapons for the Black Hand.
Who else do they make weapons for?
Anybody that will pay for them, parcero. And I've heard there are some pretty interesting individuals on their client list.
Well, that just means that they have an excellent sales team. And doesn't that mean more money into the factories here in Solis? Oye, just stop insulting the advertisers, okay? They're going to fire somebody because of this someday, and it's not going to be you, Santiago. For whatever reason, they view you as indispensable to the Tiago and Santiago show.
They probably just don't want to pay for a new sign on the door.
Probably. But they will fire someone more dispensable. Someone completely useless to the operation of the show. Someone like, no lo sé, Rafael. And Rafael needs this job very badly, or his wife will most certainly divorce him. Is that right, Rafael? See? See? He's nodding very vigorously through the glass.
I can see that. Fine. Let's just move on, okay? So what were you going to talk about?
I forget. Let's just step aside for a moment so we can collect our thoughts.
Hey, at least Grupo Prospero got a very long live read. It would normally cost a lot of money for us to talk about a sponsor for that long.
I'm sure they are very grateful. We'll be right back.
Tiago and Santiago.
That's ridiculous.
Please fire us.
Tiago and Santiago. Now, with 250% even more attitude.
Have you ever wondered who provides all of the state-of-the-art equipment, armaments, and vehicles for the Black Hand? It's Grupo Prospero. From the tanks on the ground to the jets in the sky. From the assault rifle to the rocket launcher. Grupo Prospero has been manufacturing only the best weapons and equipment for over 50 years. We're also a significant contributor to the Solino economy, providing thousands of jobs for anyone willing to work hard and get the job done. Grupo Prospero, proud supporter of the Black Hand.
On the next Jóvenes y Bellos, a reversal of fortune.
My mother's will very clearly states that the oldest living heir will take control of the company. Maria, you do not even share a drop of our family's blood.
I beg to differ, Nicolas.
Mama!
Maria is not only your sister, but your twin. And 8 minutes older as well.
Not if I have anything to say about it.
Gustavo!
All that and more, next week on Jóvenes y Bellos.
Hey, idiotas.
I need a bath now. So rude.
Two guys you wouldn't want to bring home to your parents. The Tiago and Santiago Show.
You're listening to Tiago and Santiago. Eso, Santiago. I know I give you a hard time on this show.
Todo está bien, Tiago. I can take whatever you can give.
I know. That's what I tell people. I seem to be the only one that remembers that you are an ex-Black Hand or former Black Hand. Which do you prefer?
I don't really care either way. Pero sí, it's true. I went through the training and then served for one tour with the Black Hand.
Ah, bien. And did you rack up a lot of kills on your tour? Eliminate some tangos?
No, señor. I was lucky enough to be posted here on Solis. That's always been the quiet assignment. Until now, that is.
Claro. Not very quiet these days.
But it was then, especially where I worked.
Waste disposal?
That's not a real division of the Black Hand, no. I was on communications.
Ah, no tangos.
No tangos, Tiago. Just a lot of relaying of reports from one coronel to another.
Did you ever get to scream, hostile contact?
No.
How about, you are going to die today, hueputa?
No, not that either.
I am going to hang you by your entrails, weón.
Ah, disgusting, no.
I think you missed the point of joining, Santiago.
Actually, Tiago, I joined to get training from one of the most technically advanced military forces on the planet.
But you didn't even leave the country. Let's leave the elimination of tangos aside for one moment. I know for a fact that the Black Hand also do some really good disaster relief work in other countries as well. We've seen the footage of them all over the world, from other parts of South America to Southeast Asia to Africa, helping citizens rebuild after countless disasters.
Hey, so I have seen that footage.
So you didn't do any of that kind of service either?
No, I did not.
And then you left the service after one tour and then ended up doing radio. Buen trabajo.
It's easier work than most, Tiago.
At least you got to wear one of those cool masks. Por favor, Santiago, tell me you wore one of those masks.
No, I did not. Back when I served, the Black Hand did not wear masks when they were stationed in Solis.
You were the worst Black Hand.
Wearing masks at home? This is a relatively new development, and one that I find a little disturbing.
I think they make people look pretty tough.
Claro. But why would a Black Hand soldier need to hide his face here on Solis? What are they doing that they need to hide their identities?
Probably just something they got used to do when they were overseas. They didn't want to have their faces known while they were doing all of that good work. Sort of like giving to charity anonymously.
I just think it's unfortunate how things are now. Seeing a Black Hand in Solis used to be a thing of comfort for a lot of people. When I used to be on patrol, the people I met actually knew my name and knew that I was there to help them. Now, all they see is the masks.
Wow, Santiago, that's quite an interesting opinion. I did not know that you were such a traitor.
Ay, por favor, Tiago.
No. Let's all assume that the Black Hand are out there to get us and would kill us without any hesitation.
I am not saying that.
Oh, the Black Hand are so scary. They're going to pick me up off the streets and lock me up for doing nothing.
We've actually all heard these stories.
You know, Santiago, I've never had a problem with the Black Hand. And you know why that is? Because I am a law-abiding citizen of Solis. And as long as you are too, you have nothing to worry about. And you used to be one of them too, huh?
I am very happy that we had a chance to have this important discussion about the careful balance that a nation must strike between the need for individual freedom and the need for security.
I can't believe you.
We'll be back with more of the Tiago and Santiago show. Don't give me that look, Rafael. See, I'm sending us to break for once. Rafael, hágale!
Traitor.
Oye. I think I just heard the entire nation of Solis get dumber.
This is the Tiago and Santiago show.
You've had a long and productive day at the factory. You arrive back at your house only to have a spouse that yells at you and children that need constant attention. All you want to do is be treated with respect. So you open a delicious bottle of Vina La Gema. Vina La Gema is a libation of choice for the wealthy at a reasonable price. You may not be able to afford a palace, but you can still drink like royalty. Vina La Gema.
On the next Jóvenes y Bellos, there's bound to be trouble in paradise.
I am so happy to finally be free of my husband.
I as well, mi amor.
I haven't gone anywhere, amorcito.
Gustavo!
All that and more, next week on Jóvenes y Bellos.
Well, there goes another sponsor.
That one was your fault.
You're listening to Tiago and Santiago.
More Tiago and Santiago here.
Tiago, you've mentioned many times about how you're a big fan of the TV show Diego El Santo. Just in case there are any people left in Solis that have not seen the show, why don't you talk about it for a little bit?
Oh, that would make me so happy. I could talk about that show all day.
And you do, off the air, never stopping, even when no one in the room appears to be listening.
Pues, the show takes place 500 years ago. West Solis was a beautiful, wild, untamed land.
Not the homogenized pinnacle of human civilization that it is today.
Shh, Chito. Diego El Santo time is Tiago time.
Tiago time?
Where was I?
Untamed.
Sí, bien. Solis was an untamed land where, until the intrepid adventurer known as Diego Espinosa de Málaga arrived on our shores, no man had set foot before.
Except for the people that already live here.
I mean, sí, except for those people. So this is the land that Diego El Santo comes to, and it's the first shot of the show. A conquistador's boot plunges into the sand of Asolino Beach. We come around and we tilt up to see what I can objectively say is the handsomest man I ever laid eyes on. No offense to you or anyone else at the show, Santiago.
None taken.
And this man is Diego El Santo.
Eso. Is that historically accurate?
What?
Was Diego Espinosa de Málaga a handsome man?
I don't know. Who cares? The point is that this man is, as well as being a skilled marksman and fighter.
Claro.
I can't believe you don't watch this show, Santiago.
As I've said before, I'm more of a reader. You were saying that the show starts with the boot of an attractive gentleman. What happens after that?
Just watch the show, okay? He meets some of the local people.
That must be the Cacha tribe.
See, the Cacha. And these are some pretty tough individuals. You can tell by just looking at them. But over the course of the first season, Diego uses his charisma and his intellect and his fighting skills to show the Cacha that the Espinosas are people that you want as your friends. See or no?
So they become allies?
Well, I don't want to spoil the show, but yes. And then he helps the Cacha by starting a civil war within the rival tribe, the Aipa, causing a faction of them to rebel against their evil king named Otorongo. And I've already said too much. There's still people who are catching up on the show, unlike you, Santiago, and I don't want to ruin it for them.
Bien, I'm sure they all appreciate that. So is it safe to say you are one of the bigger fans of the show, Diego El Santo?
I think I'm probably the biggest fan ever.
Well, you're going to like the surprise we have for you today, then. Because on the phone...
You're kidding me.
We have...
I cannot believe it.
The actor that plays Diego Espinosa de Málaga himself, Jacobo Rojas.
Buenas, Tiago and Santiago.
Is this really him? Is this really you, Jacobo?
Sí, it's me, Tiago.
It sounds like him.
No one is tricking you, Tiago. It's him.
Dios mío, I have so many things I want to tell you and ask you.
I heard some of them already.
You did? Well, good. I'm not ashamed of anything I said. Bien, question one. How did you go about approaching the role of such a great historical figure as Diego Espinosa?
Pues, I felt a real responsibility to be true to the role. This was a flesh and blood human being we are talking about. And an ancestor to one of the most influential, powerful men of this century, Oscar Espinosa. It was very important that I get the performance just right.
I think you're doing an amazing job. So, are you on the set right now?
We are.
And what's going to be happening on the next season of Diego El Santo? It seems like the Espinosas have pretty much eliminated all of their threats. The Cacha and the Aipa tribes have been united.
Hey, what happened to no spoilers?
And the bloodthirsty war chief named Otorongo has been killed.
The most dangerous work is still ahead, Diego. The indigenous tribes may have been united, but they are still not part of the colonies yet. And there are dangerous factions within each tribe that do not appreciate the benevolence of Diego's rule.
Oh, it sounds like it's going to be very, very exciting. I cannot wait to see it. Do you mind if I ask a couple questions that aren't about the next season?
Claro. It would be nice to talk about something else for a change.
Do you do all of your own stunts? Because Diego Espinosa has some pretty intense action scenes where he's defending his people from an onslaught of angry tribesmen or putting down some insidious mutinies in his ranks.
I do. I do perform most of my own stunts. I train very hard to try to make the action look as real as possible.
Oh, it looks real. Another question. Do you ever hang out with Oscar Espinosa, you know, for research purposes?
No. Oscar Espinosa is a very busy man, and the people we are portraying have been dead for hundreds of years, so...
If you do, could you ask him about Project Iyapa? Because Santiago keeps bothering me about that thing.
No. I probably won't do that.
Bien. Another question. You have had a lot of romantic scenes with various cast members over the years. Who was your favorite for those? Fernanda, Regina, Catalina, and did they lead to any real-life intimacy? Were you actually naked in those scenes?
They're actually telling me I have to go now. Gracias, Diego. Gracias, Santiago. I hope you all enjoy the next season of Diego El Santo when it comes out next year. Adios, parceros.
Cuídate, mi gran amigo.
Qué bien. Very professional, Tiago.
I get a little nervous.
That was one of your worst interviews yet. And that is quite an achievement.
I shut your mouth, Santiago. Nobody likes you. We'll be back with more Tiago and Santiago show.
I am the smartest man alive. Your entire knowledge base is internet memes.
It's Tiago and Santiago.
Need to find some place to eat? Need to be able to bring the whole family? Need it to be kind of noisy? El Rancho Viejo has all of what you're looking for. We've got arepas and empanadas and more. We have the most delicious and authentic traditional Solino cuisine that you can find anywhere, and we serve it fast. It's like going to visit your abuela, except that you'll be in and out of the building in less than 5 minutes. Come down to El Rancho Viejo.
On the next Jóvenes y Bellos, a family affair.
Let us go to the amusement park, mi amor.
I wish I could, but I cannot ride the roller coaster. I'm pregnant.
But how can that be?
I've been sterile since the mining accident.
I know, mi amor. You are not the father.
But I am.
Gustavo!
All that and more next week on Jóvenes y Bellos. Tiago and Santiago.
That's ridiculous.
Please fire us.
Tiago and Santiago. Now with 250% even more attitude.
Now, Santiago, it's time for everyone's favorite segment of the show.
Your retirement.
Oh, very, very funny. You still have it, parce. I don't care what Rafael says behind your back.
Tú, Rafael.
No, the segment is called Solís Hoy, where we talk about all the strange but true news stories that are sent to us from listeners around Solís.
I do enjoy this. Okay, I'll go first. Bien, we have an email from one of our regular listeners, Esteban from Cuya. He's telling us that a helicopter crashed near where he works at the lumber mill in the rainforest.
I didn't hear any reports of a Black Hand training accident.
That's probably because this helicopter did not have Black Hand markings.
That is very strange.
And because Esteban is one of our best fans and always wants to give us the best information, he went up to the crash site and saw that the Black Hand were all over the downed helicopter, investigating it.
I mean, that makes sense.
See? And when they saw our amigo Esteban snooping around, they told him to leave, and of course he did right away.
That also makes sense.
Still, a very interesting news story.
Hopefully we'll get some more information on that one. What is next?
Let's go to the phones with Andres. You're on the Tiago and Santiago show. You wanted to talk about Mina Vendaval?
Sí, I've been a miner at Mina Vendaval for over 20 years. I was there during the last incident with the tornado before the wind cannons got put in place.
Yeah, that was another awful chapter in Solís history, and I'm sorry you had to go through that. But now we have the wind cannons installed there, and that's one problem we no longer have to worry about anymore.
See, that's the interesting thing, though, and I don't know if I should be talking about this, but did you know that they were already starting to build them before the tornado came through?
What are you saying, Andres? They were trying to protect Mina Vendaval from a tornado because they somehow knew that a tornado was going to pass through the mine? That doesn't make a whole lot of sense, Andres. Andres? Oye, Rafael, did you hang up on Andres? I was just starting to talk to him.
Bien. Andres, go back if you can, okay? Moving to everyone's favorite topic of conversation, traffic. Do you know what's going on by the hotels downtown this week? Because I couldn't get anywhere in my car yesterday.
See, I'm hearing that we have an important visitor in Solís this week, a General Bernardo Torres. The good general is from a nearby South American country, and is reportedly a very good customer of Grupo Prospero.
Ah, so he is a supporter of the Solino economy. Bien. He can cause all of the traffic he wants as long as he's providing jobs for the people of Solís.
That is nice. But I don't know how many tanks and guns we should be selling to leaders with a human rights record like El General.
I won't tell a man how to live his best life, Santiago. What else is happening?
We've been getting a lot of calls and emails about an American film crew somewhere in Solís.
I still haven't seen them.
Esto. I don't think they have an official filming permit from the Solino Film Association.
No, probably not. Illegal film production is a very good way to get on the wrong side of the Black Hand.
See, but the stories I'm hearing about these people, though. Cars speeding through towns. Men and women performing death-defying stunts off of rooftops. It may be illegal, but I wouldn't mind seeing the final product.
I'm sure these Americans will have a very nice screening in a Solino prison after they're arrested.
Which brings me to my next story.
What is it? Wait. Oh, no, Santiago. Please do not bring this up again. You are really starting to embarrass yourself by now.
What do you mean? We have a responsibility to bring our listeners all of the strange news that we hear. It is our duty as members of the media.
We are not journalists, Santiago. We tell silly jokes and stories so that people can get from one place to the other without getting bored. And even then, the segment is for strange but true stories. Not wild conspiracy theories.
One of our listeners, whose identity I will not reveal for their own safety.
Dios mío.
They emailed the show and said they heard Black Hand outside of their apartment building one night last week.
Okay.
Then, the next morning, they went next door to say hello to their neighbor and no one was there.
Because they have a job.
And the neighbor hasn't come back since. And it was over a week ago.
Santiago, It really is too bad that you get tricked into believing these crazy stories. I almost feel like our listeners are having fun with you at this point.
This is not the first we heard of these disappearances, eh? They don't happen all the time, claro. But we've heard about them before.
Which is why some of our more troublesome listeners like to feed you these little lies, because they know you'll read them on air.
You know what these stories make me think of?
Don't say it, por favor.
La mazmorra.
You said it.
Yes, I did.
Parcero, La mazmorra is a ghost story. It is something parents tell their teenage children about to get them to come home before bedtime on a school night. There is no secret location that the boogeyman whisks people away to in the middle of the night.
I'm just reporting the news.
That is not the news, Santiago, and you are making a fool out of yourself.
Hey, you're probably right. Still, it's fun to talk about.
Mm-hmm. Until someone thinks you know too much and steals you away to La Mazmorra.
I think you are your own biggest fan, Tiago.
And I think that's a very healthy attitude for me to have, Santiago.
Yeah, let's step aside for a little, eh?
Sí, buena idea. It's the Tiago and Santiago show.
Isn't it amazing that we are using state-of-the-art technology to bring that noise to listeners all over Solis?
Yes, they get paid to do this. It's the Tiago and Santiago show.
Welcome back to Tiago and Santiago. ¿Cómo están ustedes? I am Tiago.
Which must mean that I am Santiago.
Yeah, probably. Santiago?
Yes?
As you know, I consider myself quite an enthusiastic reader.
No, I actually did not know that about you. I know you watch a lot of TV that is based on books, but I don't think that's the same thing.
It's pretty much the same thing.
For example, I have read all of the books of Diego El Santo. I know what happens at the end.
See, everyone does. That show is about the first ever Espinosa that came to Solis 500 years ago. The end of that show is the formation of the country of Solis.
Yeah, well...
Okay, fine. Let's pretend that I read a lot.
Bien, yes, let's pretend.
I had the honor of receiving an advanced copy, which I hold in my hand right here, of Oscar Espinosa's autobiography titled, I Am the Son of My Father.
Oh, wow, nice. I remember what I learned in school about Señor Espinosa's dad, León. But I assume this book goes deeper into that.
Oh, so deep. You have no idea. The book really gives you a sense of what inspired Oscar Espinosa to become the great leader and visionary that he is today. The hardships he suffered, the challenges he faced.
I assume he discusses the accident.
Claro. As most of us know, Oscar Espinosa's father, León Espinosa, died in a plane crash about, 20 years ago?
20 years ago.
So 20 years ago, his dad dies when León's plane gets caught in a freak tornado. And in the same week that he loses his father, Oscar Espinosa has to immediately take over as the head of all the Espinosa companies.
Where he ended up doing pretty well for himself. I mean, since he took over, the economy of Solis has been, not bad.
Uh-huh. And the Black Hand have gone from a bunch of local badasses to one of the most badass military forces on the planet.
Sí, of course. But I think what most people want to hear about is Project Iyapa. Is there anything in the book on that? A lot of people I'm talking to are getting pretty curious out here.
Well, there's not a whole lot in the book. I don't think Señor Espinosa is going to give up any trade secrets.
Sure, but...
It's just amazing that Oscar Espinosa's reaction to his father's death was to throw himself into Project Iyapa. I think most people, their parents get killed by a storm, and they think, okay, that's it, these things happen. But Oscar says, no, these things don't just happen, and I'm going to do everything in my power to try to stop something like that ever happening to anyone else's father or mother or nephew or landlord or llama ever again.
No, that's a good point. But I'd still like to know what's really going on with Project Iyapa. I don't know if you've been outside in the past 20 years, Tiago, but Solis weather is still a little volatile.
Well, controlling the weather is a pretty big challenge, I'd imagine.
But it has to be.
Santiago, I learned a lot of cool things from Oscar Espinosa's new book, and now I'm going to quiz you with some rapid-fire true or false type questions.
Okay. Go ahead.
Just a reminder to the audience that we did not discuss this ahead of time.
No one's going to think that, Tiago.
Okay, first, Oscar Espinosa is the current head of the Espinosa companies. True or false?
True, we just covered that.
Correct. Okay, next. Oscar Espinosa had a pronounced stutter until the age of 11.
False.
Nope, it is in the book. It's something he worked very hard to overcome.
Interesting.
Next. Oscar Espinosa is a fan of the Tiago and Santiago show.
I mean, I hope true.
Absolutely true. He mentions it several times in his autobiography.
I find that hard to believe.
And finally, according to Oscar Espinosa's new autobiography, I Am the Son of My Father, when it comes to the Tiago and Santiago show, Oscar's preferred host is Tiago.
There is no way that he wrote that in his autobiography.
No, he did.
Okay, well, what page?
What do you mean?
What page did he write that? Give me that book you're holding and tell me what page.
Oh, I can't. It's only in the digital version, I think. Kind of like a DVD extra.
You're a sad man.
You have no idea. Time to step aside for a minute. We'll be back with more Tiago and Santiago.
Very sad.
The best talk on Solis. Tiago and Santiago.
Hola a todos, this is Tiago, letting you know that we are giving away tickets for a live taping of Jimena, where you'll get to watch the rehearsal, the live show, and get to meet with Jimena herself backstage after the show. Keep listening for a chance to win.
The Black Hand, the world's most highly trained and best-equipped fighting force, deployed all over the globe, helping those in need and punishing those who would threaten the freedom and prosperity of others. And the Black Hand is looking for the next Solino that want to be a part of this team. This family. Strength. Order. Discipline. Service. The Black Hand is Solis, and Solis is the Black Hand. Find your nearest recruiter today.
Ay, that was really painful.
You know, you're very stupid, see?
These two men are proof that the truth hurts. Tiago and Santiago.
This is the Tiago and Santiago show.
Oh, yeah, it definitely is. Tiago, things are getting a little intense out there these days.
Oh, no kidding, Santiago. I'm just happy to be here in the studio.
Are we going to talk about it?
Sure, why not?
Bien. The group that calls themselves the Army of Chaos. I know some of my old friends in the Black Hand like to refer to them as insurgents or rebels.
Which they are.
Maybe. I mean, they are definitely violent.
Obviously, that goes without saying.
But there are certainly some people out there that have something to complain about.
I don't know. Things are pretty good in Solis.
For us, maybe.
For everyone, parcero. I can go to any store around here and fulfill any of my basic needs. And beyond that, I can buy phones, TVs, whatever I want. And all I have to do to afford that is to provide an honest day's work.
I don't think everyone shares your idea of what is an honest day's work.
Sure, we pre-tape a lot of our segments and interviews, and I only really work 4 hours a day.
If we can even count that as work.
Cómico, Santiago. Muy cómico, huh? I can't help it that the market has set a high price for my services.
Not as high as the price it says for me.
What?
Nothing.
You make more than me?
The point is, Tiago, that you and I might have it slightly better than some of the other people of Solis.
Okay, maybe you have a point there.
Gracias.
But that still doesn't mean that people should resort to violence if they don't like what's going on here.
No, they shouldn't. Unless, of course, there really is no other choice.
What are you talking about, parce?
Nothing.
I didn't realize I was sitting across from such a radical.
Let's go to the phones. Looks like a lot of people want to talk about this particular issue.
Oh, wow, look at the screen. Where should we start? Okay, let's go to line two. Buenas, you're on Tiago and Santiago.
Hello, Tiago. Hello, Santiago. I love your show very much. But I have to say, I think Santiago sounds like he doesn't like Solis very much. I have no problem with this country. In fact, I love it. I may have to work for 70 hours a week in a factory to be able to pay for rent and groceries, but I get to live in the best country on earth. So, I don't want to be mean, but I may have to scrape off the Santiago half of my Tiago and Santiago bumper sticker.
Oh, do not do that, senora.
70 hours? Did you say 70 hours a week? See, no, you should definitely quit that job. That sounds awful. Eso, I'm not saying you need to join Santiago's revolution.
Qué tonto.
But you should try to find another job right now.
You make it sound so easy.
Gracias. Let's go to another call. Hágale, you're talking to Tiago and Santiago.
This army of the chaos people or whatever, whether they have a point or not, they seem dumb to take on the Black Hand. The Black Hand are pretty much invincible.
Eso? I personally wouldn't mess with the Black Hand.
Finally, something we can all agree on. Thanks for calling, senora. Bien, let's take one more call before break. And hola, you're on the air with Tiago and Santiago.
I have a question. Why am I even listening to you guys talk about this? It's not like we can trust your opinion. We all know who owns your station. I'll give you a hint. It's a division of Espinosa Tep.
Okay, that's great. Thank you for calling, senor. I'm thinking we should probably take a break, Santiago. Sí o no?
That's probably a good idea.
Sí, along with maybe firing our phone screener. Yes, I'm talking about you, Rafael. Okay, amigos, we'll be back with more Tiago in Santiago show.
I love these guys. Love them or hate them, you got to listen.
Did you hear what they said?
You never know what's going to happen next on the Tiago and Santiago show.
When it comes to driving an automobile, there is only one name you can trust. Prisa Auto. Whether you're looking for the majestic beauty of the Prisa Sol, the dynamic thrill of the Azo 3, or the raw power of the Extendidesa, Prisa has whatever you're looking for. So, come on down to your local Prisa dealer.
On the next Jóvenes y Bellos, a family affair.
Let us go to the amusement park, mi amor.
I wish I could, but I cannot ride the roller coaster. I'm pregnant.
But how can that be? I've been sterile since the mining accident.
I know, mi amor. You are not the father.
But I am.
Gustavo!
All that and more next week on Jóvenes y Bellos.
Get off of me, huevón!
Oh, they're not gonna like that upstairs.
Cover your ears, but not if you're driving. It's Tiago and Santiago.
More Tiago and Santiago for you.
¿Qué hay, amigos?
Another amazing show brought to you by Grupo Prospero, pioneers of Solino security for over 50 years. So, Santiago?
That's a little weird, isn't it?
What is?
That we are sponsored by Grupo Prospero?
No, we have a lot of sponsors. Prisa Auto, Espinosa Telecom, Colibri. They pay somebody some money, not me personally, but somebody, and then we either mention them on the air or we produce a commercial for them and play that when you and I are not talking. It is very standard.
Sí, but I was doing some research on Grupo Prospero.
Santiago, do you know what we do not need right now?
What is that, Tiago?
We don't need a patented Santiago diatribe about one of our sponsors. Your complaining has cost us so many lucrative advertising deals over the years.
It can't be that many.
Pulso?
Their phones had terrible battery life.
Nucleo?
My computer could never handle Black Hand First Strike on max settings.
Jose Medio?
Well, their shirts made me look bloated.
Santiago?
Oiga bien, you made your point, but this is different.
How?
This is less a result of my very discriminating taste, and more from a morality point of view.
Grupo Prospero is one of the leading providers of weapons, vehicles, and munition to the Black Hand. The Black Hand protects Solis from threats, both foreign and domestic. Therefore, we want the Black Hand to have very good weapons, si o no? Ergo...
Was that Latin?
Ergo, Grupo Prospero is a good thing, and I'm proud to have them as a sponsor for our show.
But why are they even advertising on our show? Do they have a lot of customers among our listeners? Are they hoping Esteban from Kunai is going to suddenly decide he'd like to purchase an attack helicopter to commute to the lumber mill or buy a turret to protect his backyard?
I think it's more of a public service announcement. You know, make sure that people know that they are being protected by some of the best soldiers using the best equipment.
See, but they don't only make weapons for the Black Hand.
Who else do they make weapons for?
Anybody that will pay for them, parcero. And I've heard there are some pretty interesting individuals on their client list.
Well, that just means that they have an excellent sales team. And doesn't that mean more money into the factories here in Solis? Oye, just stop insulting the advertisers, okay? They're going to fire somebody because of this someday, and it's not going to be you, Santiago. For whatever reason, they view you as indispensable to the Tiago and Santiago show.
They probably just don't want to pay for a new sign on the door.
Probably. But they will fire someone more dispensable. Someone completely useless to the operation of the show. Someone like, no lo sé, Rafael. And Rafael needs this job very badly, or his wife will most certainly divorce him. Is that right, Rafael? See? See? He's nodding very vigorously through the glass.
I can see that. Fine. Let's just move on, okay? So, what were you going to talk about?
I forget. Let's just step aside for a moment so we can collect our thoughts.
Hey, at least Grupo Prospero got a very long live read. It would normally cost a lot of money for us to talk about a sponsor for that long.
I'm sure they are very grateful. We'll be right back.
Tiago and Santiago.
That's ridiculous.
Please fire us.
Tiago and Santiago. Now, with 250% even more attitude.
Have you ever wondered who provides all of the state-of-the-art equipment?